Hey, this is Notser, and this is a look at the late-tier American battleships. At Tier 7, we've got the Colorado, 8 406mm guns, big upgrade from the previous tier, which is 356. You can actually do some damage with these guns. The AA's pretty good, speed, horrendous. The concealment is, it's going to get better with the next tiers. The armor is 25mm in the bow and stern, so your guns can overmatch. Pretty much everything can overmatch, except for a handful of ships, so just keep that in mind. So, the Colorado, this is one of those ships that, you really want more speed. If you're top tier, it's not terrible. Most of the time, though, you're mid to bottom tier, and it is awful. It's horrible. You might run into the Iowa, which has a 33 knot top speed. You're giving up 12 knots base. That's not including the signal flag, so just keep that in mind. Armor, you really take damage from everything, but your guns are good. Your guns are really good, and your AA is pretty fantastic also at this tier. But I'm going to say this, like I say it always, the Colorado is the ship where you have to make sure that you are going with someone, you don't get overrun. It's easy to overrun the Colorado, and they will eat you up. You want to make sure you're a part of the main front. You don't want to ever get into a situation where you can't handle yourself. And that happens a lot as a slow ship. So just keep that in mind. But the guns can work out. AA is great. At tier 8, we've got the North Carolina. Now here we go. 9 406mm guns. Great AA protection. We're getting into the territory where it's almost overpowered. The AA, 27.5 knots. Oh, it's great. The concealment, fantastic, almost a super heavy cruiser. It's got 32mm in the bow. It's just a massive upgrade over all the other previous American battleships. The Citadel is pretty low to the waterline. Overall, I have a fantastic time with the North Carolina. Good accurate guns. For the most part, this will absolutely allow you to dominate. Initially, the accuracy was poor. They have buffed it. The accuracy is pretty good. You might notice that the velocity is a little sluggish compared to a couple battleships, but honestly, it doesn't affect me with my playstyle. I try and move closer to the enemy, and I angle as best as I can. So 32mm, what is significant about that? Well, there's only one ship in the game that can overmatch that. And most of the time, you will never fight it. So you can maintain a bow on armor setup if you need to tank damage. It's pretty nimble, absolutely the best AA tier for tier. If you're an aircraft carrier, you don't want to attack this. You really don't want to attack this. You only attack this ship if you absolutely have to. Its torpedo protection, it gives up a little bit compared to the Alabama, and we'll get there, but great AA, great accuracy of the guns with the high Sigma rating. And it's extremely fast, so it can get around and do damage. At tier 8 again, we have the premium Alabama. Recently released 9 406mm guns. Great AA again. Slightly tweaked mid to long range. Short, medium to long compared to the North Carolina in the AA department. But it's basically the same. 27.5 knots, great speed. It's a shorter ship than the North Carolina. And it has a faster rudder shift, so it's a little bit more nimble feeling. Slightly worse concealment, but that's not really noticeable. No person will really notice that compared to the North Carolina. What you get with the premium Alabama is accurate guns, once again, great AA protection, good torpedo protection, good agility. It's a great package to me. They lowered the Citadel before it was released, and it goes along with the ships that we saw, the North Carolina, and then obviously the Missouri, the Iowa, and the Montana. It's really hard to Citadel at long range now. You've got to get comfortable with where the shell's going to go. It's also very hard to Citadel at extremely close range because the waterline is actually slightly above the Citadel on the Alabama. It is very slightly to the point where you could almost not even discern the differences between this and the next ships, but it is there. I believe the Alabama is, for all intents and purposes, immune to Citadels at point-blank range. Medium range, long range, obviously not. If they get a good arc on the shell and it goes in right at the waterline, it'll dip down and go into that Citadel. However, Alabama Nimble AA Protection Great Guns, I always find fantastic success in it. It is a fantastic Tier 8 premium, if you're into that. I'm sure many of you are working your way through the American line and really enjoying the changes. I am as well. So the Alabama, a great pick at Tier 8. At Tier 9, we've got the Iowa. Legendary. Still exists to this very day. You can see all four. It's got 9 406mm guns. Great AA protection once again. 33 knots. Yeah, that's not a mistype. Great concealment. 32mm bow and stern. The Citadel was recently lowered, as I have been stating. So it's much harder to Citadel in the medium to long range department. You can absolutely Citadel this at point blank range, so don't do what I just told you to do with the Alabama. It's very easy to hit the Citadel at close range. But at medium long, not anymore. You really don't see that. And the great thing is, it's a Tier 9, so you get accuracy. And this is the thing with the Americans. They didn't get accuracy all the way up, but at Tier 9 and 10, you get a sort of a more effective version of the accuracy. So what you end up having is great AA range, if you go that route, which I recommend. Great accuracy, which I highly recommend. And you can pinpoint these 406mm guns, take out every single cruiser that would dare show their side, and then you can dip back out. Because the concealment is so good, these are basically super heavy cruisers. You get into the kill box, the kill zone, and you just are ruthless, absolutely ruthless. The Iowa, some people talk bad about the Iowa, like, oh, the Iowa, waste of time. What you get is an aircraft versus the Missouri. We'll get to the Missouri. You've got a little less front bow armor compared to the Missouri, but all in all, it's a fine Tier 9 ship that can do fantastic work. But at Tier 9, we've got a premium Missouri, which is an Iowa-class battleship. Slight alterations from the previous one, we'll talk about that. 9 406mm guns, great AA protection once again, 33 knots, great concealment, we know all that. 32mm bow and stern armor. The front has higher armor values, the Citadel, than the Iowa, but the rear does not. The rear is kind of very vulnerable, so if you ever get the butt of a Missouri, punish it hard. And yes, I know, punish it hard, but again, the same sort of build, accuracy and AA protection. I love all my skills as well. That hasn't really changed. It just identifies so well with the American battleships. Make the AA better, great concealment, accurate guns, turn those turrets, get in and punish anyone who shows too much side. It's really all that you need to try and do. So the differences between the Missouri and the Iowa should be apparent once you see it. Missouri has access to radar, the only battleship currently in the game that has access to radar. What does radar allow you to do? It allows you to detect targets up to 9 kilometers, give or take, for about 30 seconds. So you could roughly get 2 salvos off if you time it where you immediately fire right as you use it, and then you do it right at the end. The Iowa only has access to the scout or the fighter. Now, there are plus and minuses to this, but I think radar is better in most cases because the destroyer is so effective against you. This really just negates their effectiveness. Also, you got great income on this ship. Just fantastic. I honestly have... I am deadly in my Missouri and deadly in my Iowa. They're basically the same ship. At Tier 10, we've got the Montana. 12 406mm guns, great AA protection again, 30 knot speed. It's not quite as concealed as the Iowa, the North Carolina, the Alabama, and the Missouri, but it's pretty good compared to all the other battleships at this tier. It's got 32mm front and rear. The Citadel was lowered. It is difficult to Citadel at medium to long range comparatively to the previous version. However, I always see players, and I do it too, you get cocky, you show too much side. The differences between this and the other battleships that I just talked about is that you have an extra gun turret in the rear, and you want to make use of it, right? Well, you've got to fight those tendencies and be disciplined. Only use it when you can't be punished. and I'm deadly serious about this, that is what baits a lot of Montana damage, is when you want to bring that second gun in the rear online when you should have just been using the front two guns. Stay bow on, only the Yamato can overmatch. Play as effectively as you can within the bounds that are established previously. But with 12 guns, what does that really mean? It means that destroyers should be extremely afraid of you. You're very effective at killing destroyers because of the 12 guns. It just does awesome damage. Very accurate. I mean, the guns are extremely accurate. You get the same package that you got on the Iowa, the Missouri, the North Carolina, the Alabama. I can't speak any highlier about the American Battleship line late tier. They are the most fun experience in the game, and it makes up for all the slow ships that you had to go through in difficult times. It really is. At this point, in the current meta, in the current way the game is played, these guys are the top dogs, in my opinion. Great AA protection, great gun handling, great turret traverse. Armor's much better now. You could be a little bit more aggressive. It's harder to Citadel. It feels great. I hope you enjoyed seeing the late-tier American battleships. I can't wait to show you the next line at some point. I don't know which one, but I hope you could take this and build on it with your American lines, or build against it. I hope you have a fantastic day, and I'll catch you next time.